紹介するわ。ユーロ空軍のエース、シキナミアスカ・ラングレー隊員。第二の少女、ヘバー2号機、担当パイロットよ。
所詮0号機と初号機は、開発過程のプロトタイプとテストタイプ。けど、この2号機は違う。これこそ実戦用に作られた、世界初の本物のエヴァンゲリオンなのよ。正式タイプのね。
は
ぁ。あんたバカ？
Hello everyone, today we're going to be doing another unboxing, and here we have the statue from the manufacturer Prime1Studio, a 1/4 scale statue of the character Asuka Shikinami Langley, entry plug interior from the series Evangelion. Just in case you don't know, Shinseki Evangelion, or Neon Genesis Evangelion, is an anime original released or aired in 1995 by studios Gainax and Tatsunoko Production. Or the main story writer or storyboard director was the infamous Hideaki Anno. The series also has a manga adaptation going by the same name, Shinseki Evangelion, which was published in 1994, serialized in Shonen Ace or Young Ace by the mangaka Sadamoto Yoshiyuki. So this statue here is actually based on the Evangelion movies, which there's actually a set of four going by the name Evangelion Shingeki Joban, or should I say Rebuild of Evangelion, because just in case you didn't know, in this TV series Asuka was named Asuka Soryu Langley, but in the movie she's called Asuka Shikinami Langley, so they just named them differently from movie. So since she's called Shikinami, this is actually based on the movie version. So as you can see here in the background, this is actually the statue's box. It's actually pretty large, so I'm not able to have it rotating in 360 like I have with other figures. So I'm just giving you like close-up shots and other, you know, close shots to each side of the box. So without holding you guys back, let's just take her, or let's just remove her out of the packaging and see how she comes. So as you can see here straight out of the packaging, we can see here it actually comes with a giant styrofoam casing, which actually has two layers to it. You can see here, this is the first top layer to it, where it has actually the smaller parts and Asuka in the top layer. And I don't know what the empty space is for, but it's just there to be there. Maybe we were gonna include other stuff, but who knows. But as you can see here, she is wrapped in cellophane and she is protected from, you know, getting damaged while transport. But just in case, make sure you analyze everything in the box. See, here's actually the bottom layer, which is actually the heaviest part of the box, or the styrofoam, is the more main pod, or the entry plug. And as you can see here, it is in its part. So like I said, before you ever actually set it up together, make sure you analyze everything that's in the box. So it is wrapped in cellophane. So let's just remove everything and see how it looks. So before we get into the statue, as you can see here, it does have the assembly instructions guide. As you can see here, this is a back front page, and this is the front where it shows the statue complete and also what comes in the packaging. So as you can see here, it has like numbers on it. So just in case you get confused, because I know the hair piece is a little bit confusing. This is the back of the sheet, which comes with how you assemble it together. And there is a warning notice on the side here, which does tell you, so just in case that any piece does not fit good, like the hair, which I did have struggled with the Ray's hair, you could actually blow dry it, or you know, warm it up a little to adjust the piece, which makes it flexible. So don't worry guys, we'll go step by step in this video. So here's the bottom of Asuka's base. As you can see here, we're not actually going to be seeing this ever again, so after I set it up, but this is a close-up of what it actually looks like. You do have the number of your statue at the bottom here, which I'm covering on purpose, and also we have Asuka's, like a little picture of Asuka on the thing. So that's pretty neat. I do like that. Always everything unique when it comes to each statue. As you can see, here's actually the base, which nothing really too special. It's exactly the same as Ray's base. And I did notice that my base was actually cracked on the top area, but nothing really too major. But like I said, that's why you always should analyze your statues. And if there is any major issues, always contact the, you know, manufacturer where you purchased it from. So just to see if they can help you with it. Like, that happened to me a couple times, but like I said, I think this is exactly the same as Ray's base, as you can see here on the side here. But yeah, let's just move on to the next piece of the statue. So here we have is the entry plug, which is actually pretty heavy, so I do advise be cautious with it because, you know, these are actually made out of polystone, which are actually fragile. So as you can see here, compared to Ray's entry plug, like I said, I think it's exactly the same. So there's not really much of a difference besides, I think, where you place Asuka on. So here at the bottom of it, you can see here there are extra holes here where you actually insert other stuff. As you can see, this main hole here is where you put the actual base peg onto it. So let's get a look at it at the back of it. As you can see here, there's also all their holes here and magnets. So just make sure you are cautious when connecting the pieces together, because like I said, this is actually polystone, so polystone tends to be a little bit more fragile. And you can see it's almost exactly the same as Ray's entry plug. As you can see here, it does come with a mechanical siding here, which actually goes on the bottom of the base or connects onto the base, which helps it from, you know, toppling over or keeps it balanced and straight. So this comes with a left and right side, which I think they're exactly the same design. And like I said before, just like Rei Ayanami's base or stand, it's exactly the same. So let's just connect these two pieces and see how it looks connected. Here we have is the back side of the entry plug here, which is actually pretty heavy. As you can see here, they did give it like a metallic or like a gold sheet on the, or a reflective sheet, which is, I don't think is actual gold, but it's just like a piece of paper with reflective like coating on it. As you can see here, they just have like a heavy duty like beam or metal pole at the bottom here, which is actually pretty strong. So like I said, do be careful when connecting this piece to the main base. And yeah, I think they did a pretty good design. Like it's exactly the same except for the bottom here, which actually says 02 production model or plugs or unit 2 core unit. As you can see here at the bottom here, that's I think the only difference compared to the Rays, which actually says 0 or unit 0. But I think it's exactly the same. They just changed the sticker at the top. So let's just connect this to the base. Just be careful when connecting the back side. I know last time I kind of messed up and it got stuck. Make sure you align it in the correct position or else it's gonna get stuck. Make sure you be cautious when connecting it. Alright, as you can see here, we have a side B panel, which is actually goes on the side here that connects the main base with the top portion of it. And do be careful because the magnets are strong. So just be careful when placing it, because I know it tends to like pull it off your hands and you don't want to like damage it. So here is side A, and like I said, they do have strong magnets, so just be careful when connecting the pieces together to avoid from any chipping or breaking. So here is this bottom part here, which goes around or on the bottom, and it makes it a circular shape around the pod. So nothing really too special, but it is a bit flexible, but just be careful when connecting it. Alright, as you can see, here's actually the entry plug's handlebars, or the handle piece of the when they're controlling the Ava units. And yeah, there is a left and right side, so these go on the side here. So they're both, I think, exactly the same design, so I don't really need to show you like around much detail on the thing. But if you are confused on which side is which, always look at the assembly instructions guide. There is a number on each piece, so you can follow that just in case you get confused. Just don't take everything out the box and keep it separate, because then it'll be a bit more confusing. Alright, now we are in the main feature of the actual statue. We have is Asuka here, as you can see here. Like I said before, with the Rei Ayanami figure, this looks really amazing. I love the way it gave it a look. As you can see here, closer shot starting from the foot area. I do love the way they gave a glossy, sparkly, bluish type tint finish to it, or a dark blue finish to it. And I don't know if this is actually like, what do you call it, porcelain? Or they put a gloss over the resin that makes it look this shiny. It looks really amazing. I love the way it looks all vibrant and glossy. And they did a really amazing job. And because Asuka is more of a red color compared to Rei Ayanami, which is white, it gives it more, the glossiness gives it more of a pop feel to it. So as you can see from the side, it's the same thing, like a glittery, dark bluish type finish, which I think that's really amazing. I do love that. As you can see here, compared to Rei Ayanami's, all her two arms and head are disconnected, compared to Rei, which I think only one hand was disconnected, and the head. So we're gonna have to put those together. And here's a close-up shot of the Asuka on the top area. But yeah, so this feels really fragile, so do be careful when handling it. I feel that you could shatter it if you even drop it once. Here's Asuka's right hand, as you can see here. And they did an amazing job, just like the body. They gave it a black, glossy, sparkly finish to it. And or dark blue, I should say, with a black on the hand area here. But it looks really amazing. I know my camera like kind of sucks at focusing a bit, but if you see it in person, it looks really great. So this does have a magnet which does connect here, so just be careful when connecting it to avoid any chipping or damages on the product. And especially for how much you pay for this, you do want to be careful when handling it. But like I said, it looks really great and amazing, so let's just connect this to connect it to the unit and see how it actually looks. So she does have a hole at the bottom. Relax. Do be careful when connecting it, because the hands and the feet do get a little bit too close to the actual pod. So try not to use too much force when connecting it. So here's a closer shot in Asuka's head area. As you can see here, she does have a longer hair compared to Rei. And it looks really great. I love the individual like sculpting for each hair flowing in the wind. So because this is the bonus version, this does come with two heads. As you can see, this is one of the heads, which gives you like a little smug look, because you know Asuka's like a tsundere character. So yeah, I think they did a great job with the sculpting on the hair. It looks really great and amazing. I love, like I said before, I love the details on like each of the, you can kind of see like each strand of hair on the piece here. There are two holes on the top here because she does have ponytail. No, she has a twin tail hair design, so we are gonna get a closer look on those, but this is how it looks disconnected. And like I said, I think they did a really amazing job on the face. They did, it looks really great. It captures her tsundere-ish type, or should I say smug look to it. I think the other hair captures the tsundere look of Asuka, but this one almost looks like she's smug with it, which I do like. So here's the other hair design, which like I said, captures her tsundere-ish type angry or embarrassed look, which I think they did a really great job on the face sculpt. And same thing with the other statue, it has a great hair design or sculpting. I think they did a great job on that. So this head actually comes with two different sets of twin tails, which I think they're exactly the same, but they're just different because they both have their own set of hair piece that go onto it. So like I said, look at the assembly instruction guide and just be careful when taking it out and make sure you're connecting the right ones. So here's a bottom view of it, and here's the top view. Like I said, they did an amazing sculpt job on this. So here are the two head sculpts side by side. You can see one is embarrassed and one is smirking or smug, which I think Prime1Studio did an amazing job on this. I don't know if there's much of a difference with the hair. I think they're exactly the same sculpt wise. They just changed the face. But if you do see a difference, do tell me below. I could kind of see somewhat of a difference on like the front bang hairs, but not really too much. So here are the two twin tails at the back here that go on each head. This is just one of them, but I think both of them are almost the same. So just make sure you know which one you're connecting together with. So before you connect it, just be careful. It does get really close to the back of the pod here. So just be careful when connecting it, or be cautious when connecting it, because it kind of gets really close to the back and you don't want to, you know, damage it by hitting it or going too quick and, you know, hitting the thing. So like I said here, the twin toe actually gets really close to the body, so just be careful when connecting it. So here we have is Asuka's left hand, which you're not supposed to connect till you connect the head sculpt, because I think the hand gets really close to the hair. So just like I said before, they did a great paint job on this, and I do love the glossy finish to it, and also the dark blue sparkly type finish they did for the black area. It looks really great. So like I said, this does have a somewhat of a strong magnet, so just be careful when connecting this. And it also gets a little bit close to the hair, so just be careful when connecting it that you're not like quickly getting it latched on. So here we have is the other head sculpt, which like I said before, just be careful when connecting, because the hair does get a little bit too close to the entry plug. So when you are connecting each of these pieces, just be cautious on when you're connecting it together to avoid any damages.
We'll be right back.
Alright guys, so that was Prime1Studio's 1/4 scale statue of the character Asuka Shikinami Langley, entry interior plug from the series Evangelion. So all in all, it's a really great statue. I really do love the way it came out. I do love the glossy finish they put onto the actual statue. It makes it feel like it's porcelain. I don't know if this is actually porcelain. I know the details on the product does say polystone and other materials, but I think that's mainly because of the hair, because the hair is like made out of different material compared to the actual rest of the statue, which is polystone. So maybe I think it's the glossy finish that they put onto the actual body, which makes it feel like a porcelain figure. All in all, I do love the way the statue looks. It looks really amazing. But compared to Rey's statue, I think they're both exactly the same entry plug pod. I think the only difference between Rey and Asuka is the little peg that comes on the actual pod where you connect the character on, and also the numbering on the statue, which one says unit 0 while the other one says unit 2. Either way, a great statue. I do have Mari's 1/4 scale entry plug on order. I'm gonna wait for that one when it comes out, and hopefully I can compare all three of them. So I wonder if Prime1Studio is gonna make a Shinji entry plug unit 1/4 scale, or maybe a Kawaru 1/4 scale entry plug. Maybe. I mean, that would be cool. So then you'll have like all the characters aligned together, and maybe Kawaru's can have like a blue entry plug. I mean, I don't know. But what? Anyways, guys, that's gonna be it for this one. I'm gonna leave you guys off with close-up shots and other angles of the statue, because this statue is actually pretty large in size, and I can't have it really rotating at 360 because I don't have a big enough rotating base for it. So I'll leave it off with different angles and shots of the statue, and maybe side by side with Rey. So anyways guys, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I don't want to keep you guys for too long, so see you guys in the next one.